Hi guys, welcome to my channel, and in today's video I'm going to be talking about how to make a user's login form using PHP. So this is the part 2 of the video. The part 1 is how to make a user's registration form using PHP, and in this video I'm going to show you guys how to login those users that you created. And in the last video I created the user with the email of loblis4@gmail.com and the password of 123456. So let's try logging in that user as a demo before we go straight into the code. And you can see we actually logged in successfully into the user's dashboard, and this is just a dummy dashboard, nothing seriously happening here. So let's log out. And let me just give you guys, or let me show you guys some little validations that I did or added. Let's say for instance the user did not exist or does not exist on the table at all. Let us put instead James, and let's put actually James does not exist on the database. So let's try logging in. So we could see it gives us an alert that no user found, please try again later or sign up. So let's say the user actually exists but the password is wrong. So let's try signing in. You can see wrong password, try again. And let's try logging into the dashboard itself without actually going to the login page. I'm just changing this to dashboard. About this, yes. Yeah, as you can see, we tried going into the dashboard directly and it redirected us back to the login page, and that is due to the sessions, because we used sessions to manage the users log in time. So if the user is not logged in, you can't actually access the page or the dashboard. So let's go straight into the code. And note, I'll not be explaining how to do this using HTML and CSS. What I'm gonna be explaining in this video is how to make this using PHP. So let's go straight into the code. And you can see the first thing I did was to open my PHP closing opening tag and start my session. So I started my session and I just made an if statement to check if the button is clicked. So if the button is clicked, let this function run. And this function is just to validate data from the form. That's what this function is all about, to validate the data sent to the form or from the form. And this is also validating the data from the email and from the password. And the validated data, we are actually encapsulating it in the variable. That is, for the email we encapsulate it in the variable name, and for the password we are encapsulating it in the variable password. So the variable name and password are validated data gotten from the text field of the email and the password. So we included our database connection to connect to our database. And from here I think the magic actually starts happening from here. So this code here is to select the value from the database, or to look for the value from the database. We could remember here we made a variable called name, and just to validate the data we are receiving from the text field of the email. So what this does, what this code here does, is that it looks for the value that we have validated and gotten from the text field or from the form, and it looks for where it is, whether it exists in the email, in the individual's email. It looks for the value in the individual's email, and when it finds the value, it also takes the password and the email. So what this code does, that it selects the individual email and the individual password from the database table, where individual email equals the value or the validated value we have gotten. So that is just what this code does. It gets the individual's email and the password if it exists. So what this piece of code does, it queries the database, and this looks for, or this checks the number of rows in the database. That is what it is all about. And this statement is an if statement to check if this code actually got a value. Let's see, as we tried entering the john@test.com, we saw that the user does not exist. And if the user does not exist, the number of rows, which is this one, equals 0. But if the user exists, the number of rows equals 1, or how many users they are. That is what this code does. And if the user exists, it runs this while loop. And let me just briefly explain the while loop. A while loop is a kind of loop that keeps a code running until a certain condition is met. That's just what a while loop is. And we could see here, we are creating a new variable inside the while loop, and this variable is to fetch the array of the results. Yeah, so it queries the database, and this value here, or this variable here, fetches an array of the results. And inside the while loop, the code we want it to run is that, we are creating a variable of user and hash password, and we are assigning the variable, we are giving the variable a value of the individual's email, the role of the individual's email, and also giving the hash password variable a value of the role of the individual's password. So let's go down. This code here verifies if the hashed password and the password match. If they match, then it runs this code. If they don't match, then it gives this login error, which is bootstrap class, to see that the password is actually wrong. And let's try again. So after it verifies the password and the hashed password are actually the same, then the sessions, this is where we start registering a session. We first register our session and we give it a name, and I decided to give my session the name, and the session, the name of the session is login user, and we decided to give it the value of the individual's name, the individual's email, the role of the individual's email. So when it gets the value from this place here, when it gets the value, it transfers the value to the individual's role. Or how should I explain it now? When it gets the value, it indicates that the value was gotten from here, and the value is actually here. I think that is the explanation I can give, that this gets the values from the individual's email, or this is the rule of the individual's email. When this have actually selected the value, it shows the value here. So something like that. Then the name of the session, the session was named login user, and we actually gave the session to a variable, or we assigned the session to a variable, and the variable we assigned this session to, the session login user, was the actually the name. Let's say we tried logging in loblaze4@gmail.com. So if we tried logging in loblaze4@gmail.com and the name is loblaze4@gmail.com, that definitely means that here it's actually going to be loblaze4@gmail.com, and this is going to be the password 123456789. And yes, actually naming the session where we are assigning the session to loblaze4@gmail.com. I think that is a more simpler explanation, and this is just to set the session. And what this code actually does, it redirects us to the dashboard.php. So this stores the session and this redirects us to the location dashboard.php. So this else statement is for this if statement here, that if the password and the verified password does not match, let it actually send this error. And this other else statement here is for this. That means if the name or the email the user entered from the form does not exist or is not found in the database, let it actually give out this error that no users found. Let it please try again later. So let me just recap this code. This checks if there's a user or if a user is actually found from here, and this is the user, the value that we imputed, and it actually checks if the value is actually found on the database role, and if that value is found, or if the email is found, or any username or name or anything you use in setting your own database is found, let it run a while loop to check for the rules. And if this condition is verified or is certified, let it actually run this, and it actually sets the session to the users. I think this is kind of complicated, but let's just say that this name, this user, they are actually the same. The name and the user are actually the same. So if found the name, this code, the user, is just to store value, but this is the value we got from the form. I hope you guys are not getting confused. This is the value we are actually inputting to the form, and this is the value from the database. So if this value matches the value with the database, it changes to user, or we set it to user, and this actually gets the or sets the session login user to the value user, and it redirects us to location dashboard.php. So let's go to the dashboard.php where it redirects us to. And we're going to also check the session, but before we go there, let's check the sessions. And this is the session, and the session we actually connect to our database. We start the session and we create a new variable called users check. And we could remember now, in the last page, we set the session login user to equals user, and this checks that if the value, the user's value or the variable value is actually set, let it actually run this code. But if it's not set, let it go back to the login page. So that is why anytime we try to log in or we try to access the dashboard.php directly without logging in, it sends us back to the login page. So this check if the user is actually found, or the user value is not null. The user value is null, it's sent by us back to the login page. But if the user's value is not null, it actually runs this code and it selects from the individual's name where the job from the individual's email from the database table called jobs, where the individual's email equals to user check. So if you guys can understand what I really mean, is that this user's check is actually set to the user's login, or the login user, the session login user, and we actually use the session to actually transfer variables, or to make the variable global, because you cannot actually transfer a variable from one page to another using PHP, except we actually include them. I'm going to include this other page, the login page. So we use session to make the variable global. So the user's variable has been made global, and the name has changed to login user, and we set the session, that is the global variable, now to the user's check. We could name it anything we want. You could also name it the users as it was named in the former page. You could name it name or give it anything you want, but you give it the user's check, and it checks. It's just like the former code in the first page where it selects. That is what this code does too. It selects, but now it knows that this is not actually empty. The first code, it was test made that it was empty, but now it's sure it's not empty. So it selects from where the users check, or where the users equals to the name you give. So if the name you give is actually found on the database, so this code will actually run, and it actually fetches the role. And we could see in our former code where we gave an if statement, no, it was a while loop, where we give a while loop and we put a code similar to this in this while loop. So that's what it does. It does search, or it selects the values from the individual's email and keeps it and stores it. That's what does this code does. I don't think there's any other better way to explain this to you, so that you guys can understand. And we actually create another variable called login session, and this is just like repeating the same code that we did in our former page on the new page. Also create a variable login session for the individual's email, for the role of individual's email. So it's just like creating the same code, but this code excludes the password. This is just the individual's email to check whether the individual's email actually exists in the database, as we checked before. So this is the dashboard. Let's go to the dashboard, and you can see in the dashboard we have a session started here. We include then the session, and what this does, that it's just like typing the session there. So if the name that the user actually imputed into the form exists, let it run this page. But if it does not exist, let it actually take us back to the login page. I hope you guys actually understood what I explained, but I'll be on explaining it more, and I'll be putting it more in my WhatsApp group, and I'm gonna be dropping a link to the WhatsApp group in this video description, so watch out for that. And I think I'm gonna be explaining it more in depth. I'm gonna be coding it with you guys. I think that is gonna make you understand it more, because I think explaining it gives you an overview and an oversight on how to do it. But I think coding it with you guys will actually make you guys feel the code. So if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to this video, give this video a thumbs up, and actually comment on ways we can actually move this channel forward. Thank you very much.